Hello, I'm Richard Raffan. I just made this thin, quite decorative bowl, still very utilitarian as far as I'm concerned. 7.5 inch diameter, which is about 190 millimeters, and that's what you're going to see in this video. It's claret ash. This is claret ash. It's now September the 20th, I think. And this was turned 1122. Just about nearly 10 months dry. That will go over these shark jaws. And I'm going to be making a footed bowl here. Not quite sure of the exact shape yet, but you can see very soon, I like the sound of that little crack. Something easing somewhere. What can happen is when the lathe is switched on, the jaws expand very slightly with the centrifugal force. So if there's any little split, that the whole thing can fly apart. Which is why you always stand out of line when you turn the lathe on. Right, 1/2 inch spindle gouge. Get a foot on it first. Get rid of everything you don't want. Those little flat areas. That's all gone. And get the top face done. Just using the right wing of the tool. And the idea is to, by truing up that face, then I know exactly what I have to play with in the way of material. Right, beginning to look like an outflowing bowl here. Haven't done one of these for a long time. Right, 3/8 deep fitted bowl gouge. The space here and just carry on, keep the flow going, and I need to do that again, just going a little bit deeper this time. Running, I think, around 1500 RPM. Didn't get it that time either. Just go up a fraction in speed. No, now I'm up to 1500. So any pressure I'm putting in here is putting the tool down onto the rest, not pushing it against the wood. Got it this time. Gently off the edge so as not to splinter the end grain. Take off the sharp corner. Looks all right, don't mess with it. It seems a shame to sand that, but anyway. be rough enough for the people who like rough, and it's not smooth enough for the people who like smooth. So, 240 grit. And to get a beeswax finish. So it'll register up against that little shoulder. And the final shape of the foot will be decided a bit later. Three, it's bowl gouge, deep fluted bowl gouge. Shade sharp there. And go a bit deeper in here into the base. Much foot is into the base. I've got about half an inch. Don't want to press my luck there. So to that. Maybe we've gone a fraction far there. We'll find out soon enough. To get down to the bottom as soon as possible so I can see where all the other cuts are going. That just doesn't seem to be cutting quite as I would like, so I'll just hone that up. There is a separate little honing video so that you can see that done from the side. That caught because I had the tool just tilted up a shade. Those of you wondering how thick it is, it do go all the way down. Not very much, about 2 millimeters. Go with 180 grit on this one. There are a few little ridges. Okay, good. Now, unfortunately, I forgot to do the bottom, however, so I'll just have to do that by hand a bit later. Irritating. And there's also a teeny pimple in the center, which that little hole will go over. Might actually help center it, although that wasn't part of the part of the idea. Use the half inch spindle gouge this time. Come around the corner, that's just really kind of pulling shear cut. Yep, I think I can live with that. Now, I did undercut the bottom a bit, but not quite enough. All that's going to have to be actually turned and then sanded. So I'm quite sure if I want that. Can I get to put a proper kind of foot on this, I think? Ooh, sounds a bit thin. It is a bit thin in there, I'd forgotten. Need a little bit more character, get tapered a bit. Must be a turning mark, but I think it'll sand out. Yeah. Now that's a substantial amount done, and the next thing is to get as much of the bottom done as possible. So the little MDF pad is going to be mostly turned away. Just make sure you can see that. So there's a 1/4 inch spindle gouge. The blanks spun very slightly, or the MDF spun very slightly, and there's a little ring of it coming off. How inconvenient. No. See a little step just in there somewhere. Step up. Corner of 240, just grip just to get in there. Waxy sock. I'd really like to turn this whole thing off, but it's going to be extremely difficult. Oops. MDF tends to take the edge off the tool. How macho am I feeling? So you just need to be able to withstand the heat. Oh, right. All that's keeping that there is my finger. In case you're in doubt, there you are. Right. It's not getting any more sanding than that. And that is pretty thin.